कोई रेप करता है तो हैव यू एवर हर्ड दैट, हाँ हाँ मैंने ही रेप किया मुझे अरेस्ट कर लो, ओके okay, इसलिए बोलेंगे कि हाँ वॉट एवर पायल इज सेइंग इज राइट सो दैट पुलिस विल अरेस्ट हिम. लेकिन मुझे कभी भी मन नहीं हुआ कि मैं वापस के अपना रेप करवाने जाऊँ वहाँ पे. कम टू माई होम, आई छुपा के मैं तुम्हें दूसरे रूम में लेके जाता हूँ. एक बार बोला कि तुम्हारे घर पे कोई नहीं है तो मैं आ जाता हूँ, तो मुझे माफ कर दे, आगे भी मैं आई विल मेक श्योर दैट नथिंग सच सच हैपेंस विद एनी अदर गर्ल. And if it is a justice, it has to go for 5, 6 years, 10 years. You fight and then you win. That is called winning. This one day settlement doesn't call winning. And people with very less brain, which is a lot in hell in this film industry, they don't even have that intelligence to understand what is truth and what is false. Another woman, she started defaming me, humiliating me, saying that I have won. Anurag Kashyap has said that. But if my using her name or anyone's name have caused any kind of pain to them, for that I'm saying sorry. Is the crime. I haven't done anything. I have only stated those things because if I wouldn't have said that, then my statement wouldn't have been complete. Richa Chadda is not our objective. Kisi ko sorry bolne se koi chota nahi ho jata.
On Spot Boy, we have Payal Ghosh, who recently alleged filmmaker Anurag Kashyap of sexual harassment. And now the actress has gone a step ahead by taking a legal action against him. Payal, you wanted to talk about this matter during Me Too movement, but you finally came out with this now. What kept you quiet for so many years?
See, during Me Too also, I tried to talk about this, but my family, my brother, my manager, they said that don't talk about this. Even fewer friends of my from the film industry, they also said that don't get panga with this, don't take panga with this man because his reputation is not good and he can really harm you. So I tried. Then also I tried, but they made me delete the tweets, the posts, whatever I have done, and they asked me to keep quiet. So many times after Me Too also, so many times I have posted and deleted those tweets because I've been forced to delete those tweets. Then I kept a guy like who is my fan. So he was also looking after me. Anytime I tweet something like that, they will make sure to delete those tweets.
Okay. So
like that it was happening because my friends, everybody was wanting me not to get into this kind of controversy. And they said that can ruin your career. This can, that can do that and this and that. But I don't believe in that. But they believed in that and I had to listen to them. That is the reason I kept quiet.
So what convinced you finally? This time you were not like bothered about what your family or your teammates will say who asked you to keep quiet, or you were not afraid of your career getting spoiled?
See, I was never afraid of any of my career or anything else. That was they were afraid of. This time what I did is, without telling, because if I post, they would have made me delete those posts. Instead of doing that, I made a video and sent it to my Telugu channel. Because I am a celebrity in Telugu film industry and I have a very good contact with my friends. Even actually before that, I gave an interview on this Bollywood drugs and all these things, Sushant case and all that was happening in Bollywood. So they took my interview and that time I was being asked that if I have ever faced Me Too. So I said like, no, not really. But yes, once it happened and then I explained everything the way I have explained after taking Mr. Kashyap's name. Before that, I didn't take his name and I said everything to them. And then my friend, the TV presenter, she told me, Payal, if you girls don't come out and talk about all these things, this will keep on happening. And other innocent girls will get trapped by these men because they have a fake face in front of people. Though everybody can understand what kind of people, everybody knows. I also know many people come and say that, we know what kind of person he is. But still, maybe the general public might not be knowing. People from the industry, they might be knowing, but general public won't be knowing. So they said, like, you're not speaking for yourself only, you're speaking for other women. So come out and talk about it, be brave. And then that is the reason I have given her the interview. And before that also, I have told about this thing to that very evening to a portal. They said that they asked me everything, and after that, the next day, I came to know that they're seeking permission from Mr. Kashyap himself. Then I felt if I don't say, maybe I'll be fine hanging in the, you might find me hanging from the fan, and they will say I was suffering from depression, so I have done it by suicide. So, you know, instead, because, and that thing, like, literally made me feel that it is not the time to keep quiet. And I immediately gave that interview to the Telugu channel. I sent them the video, and that's how it happened.
But probably they must have coordinated with Anurag to take his version, because, you know, usually that is how a journalist work, you know, hearing both the sides. So
but that can harm the other person, because no rapist will come and say that I have raped somebody. Yes, I have done that. So nobody will do that. In that case, my life would have been in risk.
So now your family is okay with you coming out and talking it so strongly all over the media or social media, and most importantly, going legal with this whole matter?
Yeah, initially as they were not, but because in my family, my father, obviously I cannot talk about this to my father or my to the elderly people. I have shared it with my sister, and my brother came to know from my manager, because he only was sending him the screenshot during Me Too movement and said, like, please make her delete those tweets. But after that, when I told him personally during this time after giving the video, then he said, okay, if it is causing so much pain to you, then we are with you, go ahead. And that is the reason. Before there, unless they said yes to me, I was quiet. But once they said yes, then I went for FIR and did every other thing.
In one of your video, you also went on naming three other Bollywood actresses. Do you as a girl feel it's fine of somebody taking out your name so openly on the public forum?
See, again, the thing is that me who has said that? I said, I have said and stated all the conversations that I remember when I had whatever I had with Mr. Kashyap. I didn't say anything from my side. And I'm not saying whatever he said is right, because that is the time he was trying to convince me. So maybe he was taking those names to convince me. I'm not saying whatever he has said means truth. I'm not saying that. I said during that time when he was trying to force himself, that is the time when he took this women name and the other many other girls that in numbers and so many things he said to me. So maybe that was his motto, to convince me, so that right. If other girls can do and I cannot. So it is not me who has said. And again, that if you go through the video, it will be clear that I said that this man who stand for women, who say I support women, he goes for the slogan like smash the patriarchy. After that also, that man can talk about his actor friends to a girl whom he knows for 2 days. So I just wanted to talk about that man, what kind of man he is and how one woman or anybody should not believe in him. See, today that is the whole thing. He didn't even know me. He was telling. So I have said these things to a few other people also, that, you know, Anurag Kashyap told me that these women. So this is how gets spread. So their name is that way also getting spoiled. So this is what a man shouldn't do. That is the thing. What he has done is the crime. I haven't done anything. I have only stated those things, because if I wouldn't have said that, then my statement wouldn't have been complete. I wanted to show that where is the respect for women.
Right. But Payal, that has also got you in the legal trouble. Richa Chadda has actually gone and, you know, obviously did a case against you, and she wants an apology and a defamation case for 1.1 crore and an apology. I recently read that you said, "Ki, I will not apologize." If you feel that you have just stated what he said, so why did not you wanted to apologize to her?
The very first thing is that I haven't defamed her. But, okay, then also after the thing has gone to court, the judge said that go for an amicable settlement.
Okay.
Then my lawyer said, okay, fine, because Richa Chadda is not our objective. She just came in and she just jumped into it. I don't know for what. She should have asked it to Anurag Kashyap, that why did he took her name instead of saying, because our case is not even clear also. How she knows that he didn't say.
Right.
So, okay. fine. So still, because being a woman, see, I have said what I have stated. If it has caused, if it had made anybody hurt, and if her lawyer said to my lawyer, she's been harassed, trolls are talking bad about her, trolls are talking the same thing about me also because I came out and talked about it. So trolls are saying, but I feel bad because if when people are abusing me, how I feel? I'm feeling bad. I'm feeling like, कैसे बात कर लेते ये लोग. सो आई रियलाइज दैट व्हाट वुड बी हर कंडीशन. दैट इज द रीजन आई सेड दैट वी विल गो फॉर एन अनइंटेंशनल एपोलॉजी, बिकॉज़ दैट इफ दैट माय सेइंग सॉरी मेक हर फील गुड एंड इफ पीपल स्टॉप ट्रोलिंग हर, दैट इज ऑल्सो गुड इनफ. माई जस्ट फॉर सेइंग सॉरी, आई किसी को सॉरी बोलने से कोई छोटा नहीं हो जाता है. बट ऑन द अदर एंड आई एम सेइंग शी इज this amicable settlement, she is started using as her like victory. Where is the victory? When there is a settlement, it's a settlement. Nobody wins.
Okay.
And when, if I'm saying for her, for her dignity, if I'm saying sorry, that doesn't mean that my statement goes, means I'm withdrawing the statement saying Anurag Kashyap didn't say me. Anurag Kashyap has said that, but if my using her name or anyone's name have caused any kind of pain to them, I'm saying sorry. But that doesn't mean you will use it as a victory to that. And and it is not yet over. The hearing is on 12th.
Okay.
And she already started saying we have won. What means this is, means she just was trying to make me do all this so that she can come out and say I have won, just for that, for the media attention. So that was her main aim.
Yeah.
So I being a woman, I was trying to understand her feelings, and I came out, I said, okay, if it makes her feel good, then no problem.
Right.
But instead of that, she is using in a different way. And the hearing hasn't come yet. Nothing has been finalized yet. It's just like, okay, we'll think about it. We're talking about it. And then she started saying that she won. What kind of mentality is this, you tell me? Means if I am thinking good about someone and I'm thinking about someone's respect, dignity, then being another woman, she started defaming me, humiliating me, saying that I have won. The Bombay High Court has done justice. What justice? There was no justice on it. It's an amicable settlement. Then where the justice come? And if it is a justice, it has to go for 5, 6 years, 10 years. You fight and then you win. That is called winning. This one day settlement doesn't call winning. And people with very less brain, which is a lot in hell in this film industry, they don't even have that intelligence to understand what is truth and what is false.
Payal, tell me one thing. When you came out with this, nobody was there to support you from the industry, whereas there were a lot of people who came to support Anurag. So how did this whole thing felt you? And
it didn't make any difference to me. It doesn't matter. It was very much expected. If you see my 2018 chat also, there also I've written that how people in Bollywood will react, because they have a lobby and he makes us medium budget movies. He gives chance to add new actors maybe, and whose films are not working. So he keeps his, I don't know. I'm just saying that maybe he keeps his conditions, and that the way he has kept his condition towards me, on me. So maybe he must have kept condition, whatever that is. I don't want to get into that. But he does that because he's a middle, means he, throughout his life, he makes films of 10, 12 crores or something. That is his status. So anyways, so obviously he is giving bread and butter to so many actresses. So they will talk in support of that, because more important is that they are his friends and they don't know me. And so as they don't know me, they may think that they don't know what kind of person I am, and I will never talk bad about anybody on this whole world unless anybody has done anything wrong to me. So if it is okay, what X, Y, Z is talking and thinking, I care a least, because I am talking and what I'm saying is the truth.
Anurag has outright declined all the allegations that you have made.
How does that, do you think कोई जो चोरी करते हो बोलते हैं कि हाँ हाँ मैंने ही चोरी किया है, मुझे अरेस्ट कर लो, कोई रेप करता है तो हैव यू एवर हर्ड दैट हां हां मैंने रेप किया मुझे अरेस्ट कर लो ओके इसलिए बोलेंगे कि हां व्हाट एवर पायल इज सेइंग इज राइट सो दैट पुलिस विल अरेस्ट हिम
सो यू आर ट्राइंग टू से दैट ही I was asking you this question because, you know, it's just that, you know, he didn't try to defend himself, but he outright said ki aisa kuch hua hi nahi hai, completely false.
Haan, toh hua hi nahi, wohi bolega na, aur kya bolega? False hai, sahi hai, that you will come to know na, let the investigation go on, there are so many other things, we'll go ahead and make sure that, I'll make sure that justice should prevail.
NCW, you had a meeting with...
What he says doesn't matter.
You had a meeting with Rekha Sharma from National Women Commission. What kind of support she is giving you in this whole matter?
See, from the beginning only, she is by me and she is standing by me and she understands everything and she knows everything and what is right, what is wrong, everything she knows. And she is standing by my side and she is helping in every way she can do.
Okay. Payal, I also wanted to know that, you know, you are constantly tweeting about Bollywood industry. Recently, you tweeted saying that ki Bollywood mein log chullu bhar pani mein bhi doob marte hain aur usse ek natural death bula dete hain. What made you type that?
See, this is something very personal and I have said that because there are so many mystery deaths and I still don't know how people can die in that way. So I feel that something is because power and money can... suppress many things. So right. That was my whole point.
The intention behind it. You also tweeted saying that ki Anurag gave works to strugglers, but later you deleted that post. Why was
because
that?
Because I wanted to write. No, I deleted the post because I wanted to write in a better way, which I didn't write. I will post it again. And this is what I have told you before also. So that is what I shared, my thinking. Because I didn't see him doing any other film, any other big project film other than Bombay Velvet. That is the only big film he has done.
Okay. Me Too movement is all false. You have also written that.
Yeah, because when I came out with this, like about Anurag Kashyap, Me Too India has posted that nobody should misuse Me Too India. How they know that I am misusing Me Too India. Where, when the Me Too India happened, that time, all the accused have got clean sheet. So, if I have to take in that way, then, and people came out and support those women, those victims, whose accused, whomever they have accused, got clean sheet. If that is the parameter, then I should say, then Me Too India is fake. How Me Too India can even say something like that to me, when they don't know, because only because Me Too India has been run by the influential people, not for girls who are new and maybe who don't have that kind of influential support. So that it should be divided or it should be made according to the people's condition and standard and status and whatever you say.
A lot of people, you know, since when you have come out, a lot of people obviously writing good for you, saying that they are in your support and it's good that you came out and spoke about it. Whereas there are many people who are also writing that, you know, you are doing it all this for publicity, just to be gain some limelight. What kind of answers Payal has to give it to them?
I would like to, those people are sick and then people are making it as a political agenda. So people like if few people are supporting me who are from different political agenda and other people are getting angry, why this they are supporting? Because they are taking it, they are using it as political agenda. So that is the real, whatever their thought is their thought. They don't know the truth. I don't know about anybody else. I know my truth and I'm fighting for it. And for the fight, wherever I have to reach, I will do.
Payal, also one question I forgot to ask you and was that, you know, Anurag, okay, industry people supported Anurag, that was there. And as you said, you know, they knew he's an influential person in the industry, probably because of that or they are friends. But his ex-wife also, wives also came in support of him and tweeted all good thing about him.
Yeah, he's so such a good man. See, he's such a sweet, such a rock star that his both the wives have said. if a good man comes in my life, I will like to stay with that man throughout my life. Rather, I'll pray to God, please make him my husband for the next 7 lives also. But such a good human being and such a nice person, still both the wives could not even live 7 years with him. Such a good wife and such a good man and such a good wife. I mean, both the wives. And even after that, he also had a publicly, I came to know, like, he was dating some 20 years old girl. She also went. Why?
Okay, lastly, when you came out to talk about this in public, in media, did Anurag try to reach out to you or try to speak to you that why are you doing all this? What do you want out of it?
No, he didn't. And even if you had called, I would have been the last person. If you'd have said me for the first day only, Payal, sorry if you felt bad about it, to mujhe maaf kar de. Aage bhi main, I will make sure that nothing such happens with any other girl. Baad mein udhar hi khatam kar deti. Lekin he didn't say that. He kept on denying and he kept on saying lies. It's okay. Let him say lies.
Well, with the day this incident happened in 2014, who was the first person to whom you went and said about this, ki ye cheez hui? Kisi se share ki thi apne baat?
Yeah. The next day I told it to my manager ki aisa hua hai. So he got angry. He said, abhi police station chalo. Abhi ke abhi wo arrest kar sakte. Ladkiyon ke upar abhi ye sab bilkul nahi kar sakte. Law is very strict. Then we thought that consequences kya honge, log kya sochenge, family reputation, this and that. So fir uske baad we thought ki we'll keep quiet. And then he said like, usko chhodna mat, usse film leke hi chhodna. लेकिन मुझे कभी भी मन नहीं हुआ कि मैं वापस के अपना रेप करवाने जाऊं वहां पे. सो आई नेवर एवर मीन सो मेनी टाइम्स ही कॉल्ड मी एंड ही मैसेज मी एंड सेड लाइक कम एंड मीट मी एंड स्टफ. एवरी टाइम पोलाइटली आई हैव अवॉइडेड हिम क्योंकि मुझे लग रहा था इंडस्ट्री के लोग हैं फिर क्या होगा. आई वाज पोलाइटली अवॉइडिंग हिम बट आई हैव नेवर एवर मेट हिम आफ्टर दैट. बट यस वी हैड अ टॉक ऑन फोन फॉर after that also few times and after Achha, that when okay. I realized that they ladki to aane wali nahi hai to fir usne dheere dheere mujhe message karna band kar diya.
Okay, acha us incident ke baad bhi aap logo ke beech mein conversations hui hain?
Ha, conversations in the sense many times he messages me saying come to my home, I'll chupa ke main tumhe dusre room mein leke jata hu. Ek bar bola ki tumhare ghar pe koi nahi hai to main aa jata hu. And ek time, even 2014 ke Holi ke time, he also called me and he messaged me and said that come, we'll play Holi terrace party and all. I said, no, I have a times party to attend. And after that, sir, if I get time, I'll definitely come. Because I was just avoiding him politely. I didn't want to say anything bad to him, but I was not wanting to meet him.
Okay, Payal, thank you so much.
Yes, dear. Thank you so much.